And a new report predicts it is going to cost Canadians even more to put food on the table this year.
Canada's food price report is forecasting an overall increase of 5 to 7% for this year. That means the average family of four will spend more than $16,000 on food, a jump of more than $1,000 compared to last year. The biggest increases are expected in vegetables, meat, and dairy. Researchers also forecast a 5 to 7% rise in food prices for last year, but that turned out to be an underestimate.
Okay, so let's get a closer look at the report a little more with someone behind the information, Sylvain Charlebois, frequent contributor to our program. He's the project lead and the director of the Agri-Food Analytics Lab at Dalhousie University. Sylvain, I feel like in our conversations leading up to this, you let us know that this was kind of coming, and here we are. This is where your numbers have crunched out to, and 5 to 7%. But again, this is not going to be easy to swallow for so many Canadians, this increase, this constantly increasing price on foods.
Absolutely. So 5 months ago, you and I spoke about Canada's food price report. So we produced our forecast. It was all bad news. Really, 5 months later, we can tell you that we're still comfortable with our forecast. It's not going to be easy. However, the good news, though, I think the worst is behind us. The food inflation rate is likely going to continue to drop in months to come. So that's good news.
Okay, interesting. So, Sylvain, it says that the prices are expected to increase in vegetables, dairy, and meat. Those are some pretty big categories, yep. A lot of your macronutrients there. Yeah. What is attributing to the rise in costs in these areas?
So we're in April right now. I can tell you that beef is going to be a problem in a few months from now. I can tell you when we're looking at farm gate prices, we're probably going to see price hikes after the barbecue season. So if you're a big fan of beef, I would buy some right now. If you're a big fan of orange juice or oranges, I would buy some right now, because it's going to get more expensive, and that will push vegetable and fruit prices higher. Bakery, you forgot bakery. Bakery is another section where we're seeing higher prices as well.
So it's pretty hard to sort of shop the aisles and think that you're going to be able to sort of save any money or sort of tighten your budget as well. I mean, if you need to eat, you're going to sort of need to find some space here. But one of the things I wanted to get into, Sylvain, with you this morning, I know you talked about this yesterday, but the optics of the rising prices of food right now, at the same time as we heard, Galen Weston of Loblaw getting a pretty significant raise last year, the CEO there. Optics here are a struggle, whether it's worth it or not is another thing, but can you talk about that in this time period, seeing a raise like this happen?
There's a corporate way of seeing things, and there's a moralistic way of seeing things. The corporate way of seeing things is the board is absolutely correct at Loblaws. Galen Weston is actually underpaid when you look at other salaries, and Loblaws is performing quite well. However, he's a grocer. He sells food, a necessity of life. And so that's really the point here. And so the moralistic view of bonuses and executive pay checks is the optics are not very good, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. And that's why, as soon as people heard about that increase in salary, they thought about two things: food inflation and that clerk they interact with every single day, how much she or he's being paid, the people on the front line.
Wow, yeah, absolutely. For some people, it's like rubbing salt or lemon in the wound there. And very quickly,
it's just not good timing.
Right, And Sylvain, we know that people are already adjusting the way they buy food, the way they shop. They're getting more strategic. Do you think that this forecast of increase in prices is going to change the way people choose to eat, perhaps changing their diet a bit? What do you forecast here?
It is changing how people eat already. We've been in this for almost 12 months now. So habits have changed. People are looking at different options. They're visiting different stores. It's no coincidence that Dollarama is offering more food now. People are trading down and sideways. But the one thing we're noticing more and more is that people aren't necessarily set on a menu before they go to the grocery store. They wait until they get to the grocery store and look for options and rebates, and that's how they design their menu, which is a smart thing to do.
Kind of like opening up your fridge and seeing what you can kind of make for dinner last minute.
Yeah.
Those Enjoy Tonight deals are pretty awesome.
Yeah, right.
Okay.
You talked about those before.
All right, Sylvain Charlebois, director of the AgriFood Analytics Lab at Dalhousie University. Always appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care.